So he redeemed us in order that the blessing given to Abraham might come to the Gentiles through Yeshua Messiah. So Yeshua is the main point here. Without Yeshua, we can never claim the blessings from our Heavenly Father. And what is really funny is that there are groups, may mga grupo po ang sinasabi, we don't need the people in Israel. We don't need the commandments. We are making a new religion. We are making a new group. But then again, as we have read, that Abba Yahweh only makes a covenant with the people of Israel. Okay, so, kung ano ginagawa ng Israel, pwede na sa akin because we are no partakers of the covenant. Okay, next. He said in Galatians chapter 3 verse 29, if you belong to Yeshua, you are Abraham's seed. And we know that the people of Israel, they came from Abraham. By faith, and heirs according to the promise. The promise of eternal life. And something, the promise of being able to defeat Zion in Jerusalem. That's why we were singing, we're marching to Zion. That is the site, that is the place where the kingdom of Israel will descend. So we will be marching to Zion. Okay, next slide. So, sabi dito sa Galatians chapter 3 verse, you are all sons of Yahweh. Again, through faith. So, the faith in Yeshua is the very beginning. It is what makes the difference for the Gentiles to become partakers of the covenant. Again, if you without Yeshua, you are not partaker of the covenant. If you are not partaker of the covenant, then why read the scriptures? It's not for you. It's only for the people of Israel and those who believe in Yeshua. Next, tingnan po natin. So, the real Jew, of course, is no longer the physical Jew. According to Romans chapter 22, 2, verse 28 to 29, a person is not a Jew who is one outward. But a person is a Jew who is one inward. By the heart. So, it doesn't guarantee that if you are a Jew, you are already saved. Contrary to what these Noahites are teaching, we have to follow the Jews. And I have a member of this congregation who said, why would I follow the Jews? I have one passenger because he was a taxi driver. I have one passenger whom I fetched from the airport. And when I asked him his destination, I was quite shocked because the destination was asking, is the red light district of Manila? Or would I follow him even though he's a Jew? We follow Yeshua. The true Jew is someone that is of the heart, spiritual. Okay, next. Let's check. In Romans chapter 4, verse 16, therefore, the promise comes by faith. Again, we become partakers of the covenant by faith in Yeshua Messiah. So that it may be by grace and may be guaranteed to all Abraham's offspring. Not only to those who are of the law, to those who are physically the Jews by God, but also those who have the faith. So we become offspring of Abraham by faith if we have the faith of Abraham. There are also people teaching that if we believe in Yeshua, it means that you have the blood of a Jew. And I would say, well, maybe yes, maybe no. And how would you convince people if you're going to teach in front? I am a Jew. Sabi ko, ako ay Jew. Maniniwala ba sila sa akin? Aside from DNA testing required, sabi nila sa akin, ako, hindi ka naman mukhang Jew eh. Pati nga yung ilong mo, yung itsura mo, hindi nga pang Jew yung ilong mo. So hindi po natin pwedeng maging basihan. And there's no need for it. There's no need for us to become physically Jew. There's no need for us to have to be Jew by blood, but we have to believe in Yeshua. Because that is what counts. For us to become members and partakers of the covenant. Okay, so next. So as a result, if we are now in Yeshua, according to Galatians chapter 3, verse 28, there is neither Jew or Greek, slave or free, male or female, for you are all one in Yeshua. And so the covenant that was made with the people of Israel, it is already applicable. people are trying to make new groups and trying to set aside the people of Israel, even their practices, and even the observance in the Sabbath, and they're saying, no, we don't need them. But then again, so to say that Father Yahweh only made a covenant with the people of Israel and not with any groups. So how do we become partakers of the groups? Through Yeshua. Through Yeshua, we become partakers of the covenants.
Okay, so next. So contrary to popular belief, Sabbath was not made only for Jews, but for people as well. He only used Abraham, the Jew, through Abraham, so that the blessings will be for all people. In fact, from the beginning, Abba Yahweh, when he created the heaven and the earth, he already sanctified, he already set apart Sabbath. There were still no Jews at that time. Because it is the intention of Abba Yahweh, it is his plan, that Sabbath keeping will be for all the people, not only for the Jews.